All right, today let us begin today's class. So, exercise 7.2, question number 6. So, it is given that triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle with AB equals to AC. The side BA is produced to D such that AD equals to AB. Now, here the figure is given. So, here AB equals to AC. And they have given AD equals to AB. So here AD equals to AB. Now, let us name some angles which say like 1, it is 2, 3 and 4. You are to prove that angle BCD, so BCD 90 degree. So here they have given two triangles. One is the triangle ABC, isosceles triangle. So the sides AB and AC are equal. Second, they have given the side BA is produced to D such that AB equals to AD. So in this triangle ADC, this is also an isosceles triangle where the sides AC and AD are equal. Now, you will prove that angle BCD 90 degree. Now, proof. So, in triangle ABC, so ABC, in triangle ABC, you have got AB equals to AC. So, AB equals to AC, this one is given. So, according to the theorem, you have got that if the opposite sides of a triangle are equal, in that case the opposite angles are also equal. So the angle 2 is opposite to the side AB, 1 is opposite to the side AC. That is why angle 1 equals to angle 2. So therefore the angle opposite to the side AB, that is angle 2, equals to the angle opposite to the side AC. So this is the side AC, opposite angle is 1. So angle 1. You have got this one from the theorem that angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Then next one, in the triangle ADC, so in triangle ADC, so ADC, you have been given that AB equals to AD. So these two are equal. So it is given. Also, they have given that AB equals to AC. So from, if they have given AB equals to AC, this one is given. And then they have given that AD equals to AB. So this is also given. So from these two equations, you will get that here AD equals to, now in place of AB you can put AC. So here AD equals to AC. So AD and AC also will be equal from these two equations. So here AB equals to AC, this is given. Also they have given AD equals to AB, this is also given. So from these two equations you have got, so AD, so in place of AB you have got AC. So in place of AB it is AC. So in triangle ADC you have got AD equals to AC. AD equals to AC. Since AB equals to AC, so you have got AB equals to AC and AD equals to AB. So from these two equations you have got AD equals to AC. Now in this triangle ADC, so in the triangle ADC, so these two opposite sides are equal. That means their opposite angles are also equal. So the angle opposite to the side AD, so this is the side AD. So in the triangle ADC, the opposite angle opposite to the side AD is angle 3. So you will write here angle 3 equals to the angle opposite to the side AC. This is the side AC. So the opposite angle is 4. So it is angle 4. Reason is the same, since angles opposite to equal sides are equal. You have got this one from the theorem. Now this is a triangle, so you will prove that angle BCD 90 degrees. So this measurement should be, so BCD, so this angle should be 90 degrees. That means 2 plus 3. So now in the triangle ABC, so it is BCD. So in triangle BCD, so you will get angle 1 plus angle 4 plus angle, so BCD, so this angle plus 1 plus angle 4. So plus angle BCD equals to 180 degree, since the sum of 3 angles of a triangle. So sum of 3 angles of a triangle is 180. Then now here you see, you will need to get BCD, because you are to prove angle BCD equals to 90 degrees. So this angle must be 90 degrees. So you are to replace 1 by 2. So here you see, so in place of 1, you will put 2. So now in place of 1, you will put 2. That is angle 2, because both are equal. Then plus, then in place of angle 4, you will put angle 3, because they are equal. Angle 3 plus angle BCD equals to 180. Then here, so 2 plus 3, so you got BCD. So angle 2 plus 3, because 1 equals to 2, angle 4 equals to angle 3. So you have proved it. So here 2 plus 3, you will get angle BCD. So BCD plus angle BCD equals 180. Then this gives, so you add these two, you will get twice of angle BCD equals to 180. Then angle, this gives angle BCD equals to 180 divided by 2. So you have got 90 degree. So thus it is proved. So here is given, so the drawing is given that in the triangle ABC, the side AB equals to AC, and the side BA is reduced to D such that AD equals to AB. So as a result, since here AD equals to AB and the side AB equals to AC, so from these two equations, you have got that AD equals to AC. How? Because in place of AD, you have put AC. So now in the triangle ADC, you have got AD equals to AC. So since the opposite sides are equal, that is why you will get the opposite angles also equal. So that is why the angle opposite to the side AD is angle 3, and the angle opposite to the side AC is angle 4. So you got angle 3 equals to angle 4. Then you have taken the triangle BCD, so this angle B plus D plus BCD, you have got 180 degree. Then in place of 1, you have replaced by 2, because 2 plus 3, you will get BCD. So in place of 1, you have got 2, then in place of 4, you have got 3, angle 3. Now 2 plus 3, you have got the angle BCD. So you got here BCD plus BCD equals to 180 degree. Then by solving, you have got BCD 90 degree. Let's take Question number 7. So here given, ABC is a triangle. Triangle, right angled. So right angled. Right angled at A, such that AB equals to AC. AB equals to AC. Now to find the measures of angle B and angle C. So here the drawing is given. ABC is a triangle, right angle at A, such that AB equals to AC. That means two sides of the triangle is equal, which means one angle 90 degree. So now this will be called the isosceles right angle triangle. So now this is a right angle triangle. So you got here A, say this is B and C. So now right angle at A, AB equals to AC. Now from the theorem you have just got that opposite sides equal, so you will get the opposite angles also, that means equal. So you got that angles opposite to the equal sides also are means equal. So here they have given 90 degree. You want to find the value of B and C. So now using that, so here determination. So in triangle ABC, so it is given that AB equals to AC. So AB equals to AC. So you have got it by given. So they have given it. So therefore the opposite sides are equal. So therefore the opposite angles, that is B and C, also are means equal. So the angle opposite to the side AB, that is angle C. So angle C equals to the angle opposite to the side AC, that will be angle B. So angle B, because since angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Now you take the triangle ABC. So you add these three angles. So if triangle ABC, so you got angle A plus angle B plus angle C equals to 180 degree. Now you are to find the measure of B and C, but these two are equal. So now here angle A, they have given 90 degree. So it is 90 plus, so angle B plus, then in place of angle C you can put angle B because they are equal. So it is angle B equals to 180. Since angle C equals to angle B, then this gives, so you add this two, you will get twice of angle B equals to 180. Then you take this 90 to the other side, so it will be minus 90 degree. So this gives angle B equals to 90 divided by 2. So you have got 45 degree. Now you got angle B 45, but B and C are equal. So therefore angle C equals to 45 degree. So here the triangle is given, isosceles right angle triangle, where the side AB and AC are given as equal, and then they have given the angle A 90 degree. So since the opposite sides are equal, that is why the opposite angles, that is B and C, are also equal. Then by using the angle sum property of the triangle, in this case, so A plus B plus C, then here A is given 90 degree and this B and C both are equal. So in place of C, I have put here B. So that is why B plus B, you have the twice of angle B, and then you took this 90 this side, then you got here 90 by 2, so you got 45. Since B and C measures are equal, that is why if B is 45, C is also 45 degree. Then comes the last sum of this exercise. So it is question number 8. So that the angles of an equilateral triangle are 60 degree each. Now here the triangle given is the equilateral triangle where the all three sides are equal. You have to prove that the measures of each of the angles should be 60 degree. So you will draw an equilateral triangle, so where all the three sides are equal. Say ABC. Now you have to prove that the measures of each of the angles becomes 60 degree. So yes, as the three sides are equal, that is why the three of the angles also must be equal, because we have got this property from the theorem that if in a triangle two of the sides are equal, then the opposite angles are also equal. So from that property we will be deriving this one. Now so let ABC be an equilateral triangle such that so here all the three sides are equal, so AB equals to BC equals to CA. Now to prove, you want to prove that the measure of each of the angles should be 60 degree. So here angle A equals to angle B equals to angle C equals to 60 degree. Then here proof. So in triangle ABC, so you got in this triangle ABC, so here AB equals to BC equals to CA. So it is given because the triangle is equilateral triangle. So that is why the three sides are equal. Now from here you will take any two sides. Let us take AB equals to BC. So you took this AB equals to BC. From this, let us take this as equation 1. So from this equation we have taken AB equals to BC. So therefore, as the opposite sides are equal, that means AB equals to BC, that means these two sides you have taken. So from this equation, so AB equals to BC, so as these two sides are equal, that is, so the opposite angles, that is A and C, also will be equal. So the angle opposite to the side AB, that is angle C, so you will take here angle C equals to, now the angle opposite to the side BC, that is angle A. So this is the side BC, opposite angle is A, so you will take angle A. Since angles opposite to equal sides are equal, so you take this as say second equation. Again from this first equation, so again from equation number 1, let us take BC equals to CA. So BC equals to CA, so you have taken this one from the first equation, so BC equals to CA. Now this BC and CA are means equal. Now these two sides you have taken, So then their opposite sides also will be equal. So here the angle opposite to the side BC, that is angle A. So therefore angle A equals to the angle opposite to the side CA. This is the side CA, opposite angle is B. So you will write angle B. So this will be equation number 3. So now comparing these two equations, that is the second and the third equation, you have got that angle A equals to angle C, angle A equals to angle B. So here that means this, comparing these two equations, that is 2 and 3, you will get that angle A equals to angle B equals to angle C, because angle A is present in both the equation. It means angle A equals to B, angle A equals to angle C. That means from these two equations, you have got all the three angles measurements are means equal. So angle A equals to angle B equals to angle C. So now from the two equations, so from 2 and 3, from equation 2 and 3, so 2 and 3 we get, so you get from this, so from 2 and 3 you have got that angle A equals to angle C, angle A equals to angle B. That means by comparing these two, you got angle A equals to angle B equals to angle C. So you have got angle A equals to angle B equals to angle C. Now you will take the angle sum property of the triangle. So now angle A plus angle B plus angle C, that means from the triangle you have added the three angles, so you got 180 degrees. So this gives, now you can take the remaining two angles, like say as the three angles are equal, you can make these two angles as angle A, because you have seen that all the three angles are equal. That is why now angle A plus, then in place of angle B I can take angle A plus, then in place of angle C also I can take angle A, so equals to 180. Then by adding this 3, so you have got thrice of angle A equals to 180. So this gives angle A equals to 60 degrees. So it means A is 60, then B and C is also 60, because their measurements are all, that means equal. So now therefore angle B is equal to angle C also is 60 degrees, because measures of A, B and C are all three equal. So that is why it means A is 60 degrees, then B and C also each will be 60 degrees. So thus angle A equals to angle B equals to angle C equals to 60 degrees. So it is proved. Today we'll be doing one more sum from this exercise 7.3, that is question number 2. So exercise 7.3, question number 2. So it is given that AD is an altitude, AD is an altitude of an isosceles triangle, of an isosceles triangle ABC, in which AB equals to AC. Now to prove number 1. So AD bisects BC. Number 2, AD bisects angle A. Bisects angle A. So here they have given that AD is an altitude of an isosceles triangle ABC. So here isosceles triangle ABC. So this is an isosceles triangle with AB equals to AC. So AB equals to AC. So they have given it here. Then here they have given that AD is an altitude. So that means this is the height. So here AD altitude. So here that will be 90 degree. So angle ADB and angle ADC both will be 90 degree, because here they have said that means AD is an altitude. Then here they have given that AB equals to AC. You want to prove that AD bisects BC. So now to make AD bisect BC, you can make it only by making the two triangles congruent. That is triangle ABD congruent to triangle ACD. When these two triangles will be congruent, that time the length of BD equals to the length of CD. In that case, AD will bisect BC. That means dividing the line segment BC into equal parts. So these two parts must be equal. And then AD bisects angle A. So by making the triangles congruent, you will get that these two angles also will be equal. That means angle BAD is equal to angle CAD, that is by simplicity. Hence AD will bisect angle A. So just by making these two triangles congruent, you will get the first and the second. So the second one you will get by simplicity, that is the corresponding parts of congruent triangles. So now here proof number one. So in triangle ABD, and triangle ACD, ACD, they have given that AB equals to AC. So here AB equals to AC, so this one is given. Then they have given that AD is an altitude. That means here the segment AD and BC will meet at, that means right angles. So here angle ADB is equal to angle ADC equals to 90 degree, since AD perpendicular to BC, because here this is an, that means altitude. Then here the last one is that for both the triangles you have got the common side AD. So here AD is the common side for both the triangle. So here AD equals to AD common side. So you have got the three condition. So first, second, third. So therefore triangle ABD congruent to triangle ACD by. Now to make the congruence, so you just take the triangle ABD. So in this triangle, so you took the side AD, that is the common side, and you took this angle, that is ADB, and you took the side AB. So you took AB and then you took this common side, that is AD, and you took the angle ADB. So the triangles are congruent by right angle, hypotenuse, side. Because since this one is 90 degrees, so this side will be called the hypotenuse. So right angle, hypotenuse, side. So here these two triangles are congruent by RHS. So as the triangles are congruent, therefore their corresponding parts are also means equal. So here BD and DC also are equal. So therefore BD is equal to CD. You have got CPCD, because the two triangles are congruent. So thus AD bisects BC. So therefore BD, therefore AD bisects, bisects BC, BC. Then number two, they have given to prove that AD bisects angle A. That means you are to prove that the line segment AD should divide the whole angle A into two equal parts. So now, as the triangles are congruent, that is why their corresponding parts are also equal. That means these two measurements are equal. So you got from these two, so from this congruence, you have got that angle BAD, angle BAD is equal to angle CAD. So CAD by CBCD. So now as these two angles are means equal, so therefore AD bisects angle A. So it is proved. It is proved. So it is very simple. Here they have given that the two sides are equal, AB and AC. AD is the, that means altitude drawn on the side BC at D. You are to prove that the line segment AD bisects BC, and the AD should bisect angle A. So you have made this two proof just by making these two triangles congruent. So first one is AB equals to AC, that one is given. Next, they have given that this is the altitude. So that means on both sides of this line AD, you have got two right angles. That is angle ADB, angle ADC, 90 degree. And then you have got this common side for both the triangles. So now to make the triangles congruent, these two triangles will be congruent by means RHS, right angle. This side you took, which is called hypotenuse, right angle, hypotenuse, and then the side. So since the triangles are congruent, so their remaining corresponding parts are also equal. So that is why BD equals to CD. That means AD bisects BC, and then these two angles also are equal. That is angle BAD is equal to angle CAD. So these two are also equal. Thus, the line segment AD bisects angle A. So it is proved. Let us take one more sum, that is 4. So given BE and CF are two equal altitudes of a triangle ABC. So now to prove that the triangle is isosceles. To prove triangle ABC is isosceles. So here, these are the two. So here they have given B and CF are the two equal altitudes of a triangle ABC. So a triangle ABC. So ABC. And then they have given the B and CF, these are the two equal altitudes. So from B you will draw one altitude on the side AC, this is BF. And from C you will draw the other altitude, that is CF, on the side AB. So as they have said that they are the equal altitudes, so these two lengths are also equal. And then here measurement will be 90 degrees. Now you are to prove that the triangle ABC must be isosceles triangle. So here they have said that one thing they have said, you are to prove this congruence of the two triangles using the RHS congruence. So they have clearly said. So here now the congruency of these triangles that you will prove, that will be by RHS. So RHS. Now here they have given that these are the two equal altitudes, that means BE and CF. So this one is given, so BE equals to CF. Let us take the triangle FBC and ECB. One is the triangle FBC and the second one is ECB. So in triangle FBC and triangle ECB, so ECB. Now let us take their corresponding parts. So from these two triangles you have got, so one is the triangle FBC, second triangle is ECB. So from these two triangles you got that CF equals to, you got BE, because they have said that the, they have given the word the two equal altitudes. So these are the two equal altitudes. So BE and CF, they are now equal. This one is given. Next you got here 90 degree. So angle BFC is equal to angle CEB. So you got 90 because these are the two altitudes. Then in both the triangle you got the side BC. You can see from the triangle you have got the side BC. This is the common base for means both the triangles. So here you got BC equals to BC. So you got the common side. So the triangles will be congruent by, so let us take this triangle FBC. So you took this angle 90 degree, you took this common base which is called the hypotenuse. So right angle hypotenuse, and you took this side, that is the altitude CF. So that is why the triangles are congruent by RHS. As the two triangles are congruent, therefore angle B and angle C are also means equal by CPCT. When the opposite angles are equal, then the opposite sides are also means equal. That means AB and AC also are means equal. That is what the triangle is. It means isosceles triangle. Now, proof. So in triangle, so FCB, so in triangle FCB and triangle EBC, so EBC. So in both the triangles, so you got one is the CF from the triangle FCB. So CF equals to BE. So this one is given. This one is given because they have given the, these are the two equal, then this altitudes. So these are the two altitudes. So now they are equal. So it is given. Then here angle. So BFC. So BFC equals to angle CEB. So CEB equals 90 degree. Then you have got the common base BC. So BC equals to BC. This is the common side. Common side. Common side. So you have got the three condition. 1, 2, 3. Therefore, triangle FCB congruent to triangle ECB, EBC by, so you have both in this triangle, so right angle hypotenuse and then the side, so you got RHS. Therefore, so since these two triangles are congruent, so you got here angle FBC, so angle FBC is equal to angle ECB. So these two angles are now equal. So ECB. So ECB by CPCT. CPCT. That means, it means that angle is B. That means this angle. It means angle ABC. So the angle is B. That is ABC means ABC. So it is the ABC. Is equal to angle ECB. So ECB means ACB. So it is ACB. Now in the triangle ABC, opposite angles are equal. That is why the opposite sides are also equal. So therefore AC equals to AB. AB. Hence, triangle, therefore triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. Is an isosceles triangle. So That's all for today. Thank you.